And who killed a pedestrian and took off shouldn't have been driving at all. His license was revoked for a DUI conviction, and alcohol may have been a factor in this crash. The victim was found on A1A near Bottle Island Road south of New Smyrna Beach overnight. WESH 2's Claire Metz reports the suspect was arrested under unusual circumstances at his mother's home nearby.
A witness told law enforcement she came upon the victim lying in the road, pulled over, and jumped out to start performing CPR. But she later changed her story, said she had to come clean. She said she knew the driver of the suspect vehicle, witnessed him hit the victim and take off.
It's wrong. It's wrong. Absolutely wrong.
A neighbor of 33-year-old Desiree Williams, this is a picture of the victim from her Facebook page, was stunned to learn Williams was run down in the road just blocks from home. Debris and blood still marked the scene. Troopers say 31-year-old Jason Wilkie, a man whose driving privileges were revoked, a man with a long local criminal history, hit her with his pickup truck, then drove off.
You know, I don't know how someone can internally, you know, handle making that decision except for the fact that they're intoxicated. I mean, I don't know.
I was just going to knock on your door. We went to Wilkie's mother's home where the suspect was arrested hours earlier. She ordered us off her property, but it's not far from the scene and very near the victim's own home. Troopers say deputies searching for the hit-and-run vehicle found a damaged pickup parked here. Suspect Wilkie and a female passenger with him on the ground, according to the report, cuddling in the driveway. The witness says Wilkie is her sister's boyfriend. She was driving behind the couple when she says he, Wilkie, hit the female who was standing in the road waving her arms.
I just wanted to see if there's anything you wanted to say.
The suspect's mother had no comment. Troopers say they still don't know why Desiree Williams was walking alone at that hour.
It's really sad.
The hit-and-run suspect was booked into the Volusia County Jail after troopers got a court order to withdraw blood. He'll be at first appearance in jail tomorrow on the current charges of driving without a license and leaving the scene of a fatal crash. Near New Smyrna Beach, Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.